one time. Yeah. Yeah. Yo, all I need is one mic, one beat, one stage, one nigga front, my face on the front page. Only if I had one gun, one girl and one crib, one God to show me how to do things the sun did. Pure, like a cup of virgin blood, mixed with 151, one sip will make a nigga flip.
Hey everybody, it's your girl. The saga continues. We are at the Baltimore Comedy Festival and it's just one hitter after another hitter after another hitter. And I got, do you like that? I
think you like that. Is that a fake Nicki? Like,
no, that's me.
That was Nicki Minaj?
No.
That was your impression?
That's all me. That's not me being.
Yeah, it's like
because
a new single.
That, no, that is my nice way of saying good comedian after good comedian after good comedian, because, you know, it's going to be one hit. He just fucked my whole shit up. Okay.
Because I'm trying to figure out what a good comedian at. Me? It's not me.
So listen, you guys. Thankfully, I don't want to be a comedian, because if I had any type of dream or aspirations, he would have just killed it. Killed it.
No, I'm saying I'm a comedian. I ain't say you weren't. You wouldn't
but
be.
But I think you're funny.
Oh, I appreciate it.
You can't be a hitter for me on the Love Below.
I'll be a hitter for
these motherfuckers. Ain't got no, you ain't funny for real.
They, I mean, but then they gonna look me up and then they were like, oh, he ain't even that
and
funny. He getting interviews.
Show.
Oh yeah, definitely come to my show.
They not coming
definitely
now.
Definitely come to my show. I'm fucking hilarious. Did you not know?
got time to talk about my shit. We no. Supposed to be talking about sex.
Hey.
So. You guys, this is Eddie Lyles.
How y'all doing today?
Yes, Eddie Lyles, one of the biggest names in DC comedy.
I don't know about biggest.
You know,
I'm
what?
A name. Because my
of
mama
the biggest
gave,
names.
Yeah, I one of the biggest bodies
in DC comedy.
Everybody in DC comedy like 5'4".
Towers over everybody.
This is all of them are short. It's just all short people. And then I come in at 6'5", I'm used to being the short guy. You know what I'm saying? Playing okay. Football and basketball. I'm used to being the short guy. Now, I'm the tall guy. It's weird.
It's all right. It's all right. So if you are an avid watcher, you would have seen some of the footage that I got at the DC Comedy Festival. This gentleman is also one of the people in charge of putting on these awesome festivals. Mm-hmm. And you touched on a little bit. We had a little snippet with him, but I thought it would be awesome to sit down and have a full-on interview with the Love Below.
Thank you.
And we talked about big boys bringing stuff to the bedroom. He said he was fast with it. He said he can move.
Yeah, I'm quick with it. I'm quick
so
with it.
So should we not underestimate the big man in the bedroom?
It's the best. We the best lovers. That's what I heard in the book.
You heard it in the book?
I heard it in the book. So this is what happened. Somebody was reading the book and then they told me. So I heard it in the book. Bam.
That made perfect sense.
You know, it's the big dudes, we want to make sure you guys are taken care of. So we go above and beyond.
So you think that gives you an edge up?
That definitely gives us an edge up, you know what I mean? Like, the one thing I like doing is eating, so.
There you have it, folks. There you have
I like
it,
eat.
Folks.
So, we good. Yeah, I'm gonna make sure you good. Yeah, because I don't think everybody realized, like, dudes, we only need you. I think I said this on the last one. We only need you for 5 seconds.
Five seconds.
I don't even, if you got good kush, I only need you for 5 seconds.
5 seconds. That everything has to be that OG kush.
Exactly. After that, after the 5 seconds, everything else was for you, baby. It wasn't for me. It was for you.
So, what is it?
So if I get you there first, then I go 5 seconds. We just had a long sex drive. You ain't even up. That was a long round.
So since your situation doesn't seem to be lasting that long, I was going to ask about bringing humor into the bedroom and how does that work? Do you feel like there's humor or it applies to the bedroom?
Like I said, I mean, like at the end of it, at the end of the day, if I got you laughing, if I made you.
That would be nutty.
If I made you. You know what I'm saying? But if I got you there, like, it's like, dog, just let's have fun with it now. You know what I mean? Because, like, all of it, we could do it by ourselves. We both, everybody know that. Yeah. We could just do it by ourselves. I don't, like, I'm doing it for the connection with another person. So is that a real connection? You know what I mean? So get our space. I mean, get our nuts, and then let's have some fun.
Is that connection something you feel like you appreciate more as you get older, or have you always been like that?
I've always been like that, because I can be with a chick and not have sex with a chick. So the connection is, you know what I'm saying, like us enjoying each other's company is more important than the act of having sex, right, for me.
Right.
You get what I'm saying? So, yeah. Like, and so I know a lot of people, you know what I'm saying, need sex to feel a connection. I don't need that. You know what I mean? So again, 5 seconds. I only need 5 seconds. The whole other 30 minutes was you. That wasn't me.
So it was all mental.
It was all mental. But as soon as I stopped thinking about baseball, I'm going to bust this nut either way.
Dang. Twice you could have ended this.
I could have finished 35 minutes ago. What are you talking about? But nah, this is, but real life, and all just that. The connection, the bringing, being a comic, you know what I mean? Most of the ladies that we meet came to our show. So it's like they already know we're a comic. Mm-hmm. So we want to make sure that they have fun, make sure you laugh. Make sure, you know what I'm saying, I'm memorable. And then after that.
Do you feel like because the women you meet or may have come across, and do you think that because you're a comedian that there's a certain expectation for your performance in the bedroom? Like, do women expect you to be the bomb? Do they expect you to be, like.
If you are fucking a comedian because you think he's going to be good in the bedroom, you're stupid.
So.
Like, what? We make fun of ourselves. Like,
what kind of interests me, because I'm behind the scenes. Okay. So I just see, I hear, I listen. Mm-hmm. I don't say shit. I just pay attention. But a lot of times, especially when I'm in audiences, I can hear, you know, the conversation among women, and it's, oh, I think he got this. Oh, I think he got that. But it's on the strength of how funny this person is.
Yeah, that's stupid.
Like, people. I'm not saying that it's not, but like, do women go in the bedroom like they thinking, oh, you about to be King Dingling because you were funny on stage? Like, dude, it's a rock of.
I've never, I have.
This is an interview?
Yes.
Oh, I'm sorry.
You hear that?
Just break up the interview.
You want some of this tonight? Come on, get in on it.
With a blunt in his mouth. Doc Mock, everybody. Doc Mock.
How you
like,
doing?
You smell like bath water.
Clean bath water, too. Fresh bath water. What kind of bath water you want to drink? Bath water after you wash your ass and stuff.
Oh, my God. I'm not drinking bath water, bro. That's dirt water. That's dirty water, nigga. That's dirty bong water, nigga.
This is beautiful, man.
So we're actually talking about sex.
Can we smoke?
And so we're breaking down the barriers in the bedroom and doing it with laughter.
I don't got no barriers. They broke. They already.
Who says that? Who says that? I ain't got no barriers, baby. Girl, one pick her thumb in your booty hole. You gonna do it?
That's even
a barrier.
That's not sex. Yeah. Who's having fun here? She can't be having fun. You know, there's lots of shit in my thumb. You're not having fun. Who the fuck's
having
fun?
Not with a thumb in your
ass. No, I mean like regular, you know, like, stuff. You know,
okay.
Juices.
But do you stick your thumb in the lady's ass when you're
yes.
in the back?
Hell yes.
If she into that. If she into that. It's all this about conversation.
But you got a primer. You do the primer? I do the primer.
Nah,
I do the primer first.
What's the primer?
The primer is when you hit it, when you put it in the back. You hit it from the
back.
Nah, I'm hitting it from the back. Yeah, lick my thumb. Then you just rub around. She don't flinch or move your hand. You tank.
If it's sensitive enough, you can touch it and feel it grab you a little bit.
Right. If it grabs.
You feel it invites you inside.
Once it invites you, it's like, okay, we in there. We in there like swimwear, homie.
Yeah. See if it agrees.
But if she do it to me, I'm stop. Stop that. Don't do that.
And that's no shot at anybody. I think that's get down like that. It's not my personal.
We got a lot of white friends.
You can't lay out of this.
Right.
Once she moves, it's a different number. It's the butt. It's not the same. You're the buffer.
She the way to stop us from getting on a Dave Chappelle special.
Right. This
would never stop you from that. Huh? I mean, really. Never.
All right. Can I start this? No.
Yeah, back here.
All right, that's what's up. All right, what else we talking about? Sex ed.
No, so she was saying mm-hmm. sometimes women feel like on stage, uh-huh. when you're on stage, when we're on stage
and
as
they
males, they have a certain expectation. I don't get that. I never had that.
About what?
Because you know, like, because some people think that because we got confidence on stage, we got big dick energy.
Yeah.
Somebody actually did say that to me. Somebody was like, "You got big dick energy," and I was like, "I force that shit. I force it. I'm 300 pounds.
I'm multitude.
You're gonna get as much as I can get you."
But you know what though? People don't realize who you are on stage is not who you are off stage.
You know that's not true.
Right. When you get really off stage.
Who I am
you
on stage?
The same nigga all the time.
Yeah. I try my best to be. I try not to, because I don't want mm-hmm. on stage. You don't want to come across as fake.
Right.
So the person that we are on stage now, we might curtail a little things on how we say things in real life. You know what I'm saying? Just to make it a little bit more funnier. Mm-hmm. But the stuff I talk about on stage. I would talk about that stuff. That all came from real conversations that I had with other people. You know what I'm saying? So, mm-hmm.
The only difference between me on stage and me off stage is I speak a little more clearly.
On stage.
On stage. I take my time and enunciate
the words.
And try not to go Baltimore, blah, 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 you know what I'm saying? Something off mm-hmm. fast. Mm-hmm. But that's really the only difference. I try to do jokes that are close to me. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? In the regular life, I'll say whatever. But this is a sex podcast. Why are you talking about jokes, man?
Because you know
it's
what?
A jokes it, with the it, sex. It,
Right, and I talk to mostly comedians, so we. Do
so how about you get the fuck up, and then I finish my interview, and then you can, and then you can do your interview
I'm
later.
I had fun.
Are you going next? This is Eddie Lyles.
Oh.
This is T. Gray. Who are you?
Oh, my name is Mark. What's wrong with that? No, I told him the same motherfucker. This is Mark. My name is Mark.
Just Mark.
No, I'm Dark Mark. What's up?
Hey, Dark Mark.
Yeah.
Sir. As opposed to Light Mark.
I mean, you know, as opposed to Good Mark.
Mm. Oh, you dark in that kind of way. Mm, so you got to put that voice on.
I don't got the mic.
I want to leave. I'm feeling uncomfortable.
I mean, you can leave, nigga. I mean, you can't leave, nigga. You can go wherever the fuck you want. That don't make a difference to me.
Like, you stay, Jay stay. Or just leave Jay, y'all both go.
I hate you both. I like it. This interview is off track.
It's what just you a little bit.
No, I was, and then you got here.
Let's stop. For just a moment.
I was trying to share in the love. I was really saying happy.
I know, right? I was saying happy. Is that what you just said?
So Dark Mark.
Your nails look nice. I like that shit.
It's fly shit.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Could you stretch a little bit?
Yo,
just a little bit.
It's gonna cost $25.
This nigga Mark is about to get a date.
What about with one finger?
not that
this nigga Dog Mark trying to get a date for tomorrow. It's crazy.
With
yeah.
the pinky.
Listen,
with the pinky right
we're going to wrap this up.
I can feel it. It's getting close. I can feel the heat of your feet. Yeah.
Where did you get this nigga from?
It's getting close.
From Baltimore. I'm from D.C. We don't.
This is what happens, you guys. This is the Baltimore Comedy Festival.
Yeah,
okay?
Baltimore niggas just pop up out of nowhere.
Well, yeah. All right, I'm out. I'm going to let them guys do the thing they was doing. I was just trying to say hi.
You going to get your time.
I like that. You got mohawk.
We good, bro.
Oh, that's nice.
Nigga, you going to leave me hanging on camera?
Oh, I'm on camera.
God damn.
I love everybody.
So I don't remember.
This guy is crazy.
Where are we? He's hilarious.
He's crazy.
He's hilarious. I can't wait to see him on stage. Remember, he got some big dick comedy on stage. He just got that regular Mark.
He got that regular Mark comedy on stage. Yeah, but yeah, I mean, like I said, like I had females who were like, oh, they thought I had big dick energy mm-hmm. on stage. Mm-hmm. Then like I've heard that, like, you know what I mean? Like out playing around with people and joking around. And it's like, I'm just confident in me. Like, right, I'm going to give you what I give you. How big is it? I don't know. I ain't compared to next to other niggas. Like,
right,
I don't.
Right.
So it is what it is for me. Like, I'm going to give you what I give you. So I've never hooked up with a chick and then she was like, oh, I thought you were going to be better because you were so good on stage. Like, no, never. But I've had chicks like hand me their phone number mm-hmm. because of how good I was on stage. So I don't know.
Well, I remember being at a comedy show one time. I'm not gonna say who the comedian
was. Please tell us.
But in my opinion, this comedian is not attractive.
Oh.
Although he's funny, I give him that. He's funny, but in my opinion, he's not physically attractive.
Okay.
And on stage, he's like, "Yeah, I just want to get my dick sucked before I leave town," and these bitches was lined up
For real? Because every, but that's what I'm saying.
At the backstage, I'm like, not, for this nigga?
I don't have a vagina, so I can't say what females feel. I can only tell you my perspective, right? And I feel like females think that funny dudes, not that they're going to be great in bed or anything like that, but they feel like they're going to have an experience. And that's what I mean by, like, dude, like, so I'm here to take care of you, make sure that you feel right, make sure I don't get my name ruined in the street.
Right.
You know what
right,
I'm saying? Like, because right, there's right, a cop, like, you were like, yo, like, yeah, I had sex with Eddie Lyles. That shit was weak. Like,
weak.
Like, no, that's not,
put
that's,
your big eyes on,
that's never going to happen. Like, it's never, I will never get famous if somebody come up and be like, that shit was weak. Like, when a nigga eyes get open, they serious. Weak. Like, so nah, like.
Yeah, we tell everybody.
Nah, I tell everybody. Because it's like, dude, like, if, especially if you get famous, it's like, ooh, you hooked up with such and such. How was it? Like, I don't want, no, that's not going in the airwaves.
Isn't that terrible? But men do it too. You all talk about women so much.
We talk about, but as dudes, it's like, I won't say it's the, because we're dudes, it feels normal for us to talk about it. Like, for you guys, it probably feels normal for y'all to talk about it.
Right, right.
But it's, I guess because dudes have been advertised of doing it and females haven't. So when you hear females, right, so when you hear females talk about you, be like, I don't think I'm supposed to be in this conversation. Like, no. So it's not like, it weirds you out a little bit. But
it's real talk, though. We do that. If it's garbage, we sound like that.
But that's, I mean, I do. I used to do a joke, like, the premise is so old, so I stopped doing it because it sounded hacky. But it's the truth. Women, if I have sex with you, you're going to tell your friends. Right, and if it was just a hookup, now I may have a possibility of hooking up with one of your friends if it was good. So I'm gonna go all out like that, cause dudes like sex, females like sex, yeah. But y'all got a lot. We go inside y'all. Y'all shouldn't have too many dicks inside you.
It's a dick limit.
I don't know if it's a dick limit, but if there was one, don't pass it. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, Every dude's different. Like, I think if you had two dicks in you a year, that's fine with me, as long as you're not married. After the age of 18. After the age of 18, if you had two dicks in you a year, I'm not worried about that. That's 6 months of dating. You hooked up with a guy, broke up. 6 months of dating, broke up. 6 months. Yeah, you know, like, that's, I mean, you need to know that it's you. That's why y'all keep breaking up. That's you. So you only fucking dudes that you together?
No, I mean,
you telling me you ain't, hold up, let's interview switch. No. You telling me you ain't never hooked up with a dude on one night?
No, but that's what I'm saying. Like, you're saying 6 months and then you break up 6 months. I'm saying like, that's not really together.
Because people be like, nah, girls, people that have sex with a whole rack of different dudes, or girls who have sex with a whole rack of different dudes, they whores. Like, not really. No. Not really.
I'll speak for us, ladies. We're not.
Exactly. That just means I got fucking high expectations I'm coming in the bedroom against.
Hey.
That's all. That's all. Because you didn't have some bad, you didn't have some good. As long as I get above middle, I'm I'm happy. I don't have to be the best you ever had. I'm fat. This shit ain't, no. What? It'd be the best eating.
Put that motherfucker finger on it.
Be the best eating.
And open up them eyes.
Yeah.
Now you know shit gets serious when that allows you.
I know. Nigga, I do ABCs. I know I'm perfect.
What?
And my numbers. But I'm just saying.
Spell a nigga name.
I can spell your name. But there's I can do it in cursive. I can do it like how you want it.
Hilarious.
But I like eating. Yeah.
But that's how people, it's funny you say that, but like when going down on a woman stopped being taboo and started to be the thing to do, that was the joke then.
You know what I mean?
To spell your name. Yeah, that's.
I didn't even know that was a joke. That's what I was told when I was a kid. Like,
what? Somebody told you that as a child.
Okay, my life is fucked up. I'm a comic. My life is. It's very weird.
No, that's real talk, though. Most comics come from a place of torment.
Dude, I started at 9. That's how bad it was.
I started at nine.
So they don't call it.
I feel so good about that, you guys.
So she was 14. And so my mama calls it rape. You know what I'm saying? I call it fucking. But The point of the matter is,
fucking. You call it rape, I call
Nah, because if it was my daughter, I'd kill somebody. You get what I'm saying? But I'm a dude. I get over it. You be all right. Like, but no, ABCs, that's what I was told to do. And then I just started getting good at it.
Wow. Yeah, she did just.
Yeah. Just, yo, stop just using your tongue. Kiss it. Yeah, kiss it. Yeah, move that hood.
And let me tell you that you, for real, have hit on so many things. And you guys are going to see how this kind of foretells stuff because you watch and you know it's coming. So I have an awesome interview coming out with Buck Wild tomorrow. I'm dropping it at 9 o'clock.
Nice.
And he touched on so many different things. One of those things being taken advantage of, you know what I mean,
yeah,
as a child. And, you know, men sometimes being damaged and not necessarily understanding that when a woman takes advantage of you, like, that's a real thing.
Oh, it fucks you up.
And you don't think about it. You know what I mean? You don't think about it sometimes not until later on in life. Mm-hmm. Sometimes not until you have kids of your own that, yo, that was fucked up. Like, you say, yeah, your mom called it rape. It was fucking, but real talk.
But real talk, it was rape.
She took advantage of it.
Exactly. But then I think, and this is the suckiest part of it for a dude, and I hope it doesn't affect women the same way it affects dudes, or most dudes that I know that have the same predicament as me. But it's like, you get better at sex, but then you get fucked up in relationships.
Right.
You get what I mean?
Right.
Because you don't even treat sex the same thing. It's like, oh, I just treated sex like a way to just get off real quick. You know what I'm saying? Get a connection. All right, cool. Connection's over. Later. And then people be like, well, why y'all don't call them the next day? Because I don't look at sex like we was getting, like we was about to go down a path of relationship.
Right.
I had sex with you. I stopped thinking about you when you stopped texting me.
Right.
So, I mean, and it sucks like that sometimes, but you get better at sex. So it's you want the dude that's going to be, like, that's why I say I don't want to be your greatest ever.
Right.
I just want to be above average. That's all I want to be. This is the dude that was the worst. This is the dude that was the best. I'm closer to the dude that was the best, but I wasn't the best. I'm cool with that. I'm just cool with that. Because if you the best, if ladies, when y'all keep telling dudes this is the best pussy you'll ever have, don't do that no more. Don't. it sounds like you had sex.
It's very a lot. Cliche.
Yeah. Yeah.
Don't say that. You gotta show them.
You gotta show it to them. Yeah. Show it to them. Just get in the average. Because if you get in the average, he'll call you back. That's all I'm saying. If you average pussy, he'll call you back because he's like, oh, it could get better.
My C game be having niggas stupid. God forbid. I only put the A game when I got married. That's how I got the ring in the first place.
Hey.
But that C game.
The C game had them tripping.
Niggas still tripping.
Humble brag.
My people know I don't give a fuck.
Like, nah, I mean,
the Baltimore Comedy Festival. Don't matter.
But I mean, you just, I sex with me is different. You know what I mean? Like I said, I do look for the connection. I do look for the connection. And I do want you to enjoy yourself while we're doing it.
Right.
And then afterwards, have fun, make light of the situation because I want us to still be homies. Because we don't know where this is going to go.
That's so important. Friendship is important in the bedroom.
Friendship is important in everything.
Yes.
And when you talking about relationship, because if I don't like you, like, oh yeah, he gave good dick. Cool. And then, you know, like, there's nothing after that. You know what I mean?
Right.
So it's like, because I don't like you.
Right.
So if we have sex and I make you laugh and then I can continually keep making you laugh, because I told you, I don't need sex a lot. Mm-hmm. Like, I'm not an information. Like, I don't. If you say, hey, I want to have sex, cool, let's have sex. Other than that, you probably hear me say I want to have sex once a month. Like, it's just like that. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's just how I am. So my once a month, I just try to go all out.
Well, high five to your once a month. Okay. High five to whoever he kills once a month.
Hey.
What kind of build up is that?
Anyway, I'm just, what?
I'm just playing.
I said I only want it.
I know, I'm just playing.
But I could do it every day, twice a day.
Understood.
Three times on Saturday, you know what I'm saying?
So, you're not single?
I was like, yum now. I ain't tell you. They don't know. Shot it. I am single. You ever heard that song?
Listen.
Look, I think I'm coming out to Beyonce for now on. I think I'm coming out of Beyonce from now on. Oh, I'm a single lady.
Y'all, Eddie Lyles is looking good. Ladies, yo, he done lost a little weight. Look.
I'm trying to lose.
So you say you single
now? No, you got a wedding ring. I don't get beat
I'm
up.
I'm not married no more.
Oh, for real? What's up?
See, cut the camera off.
I got a Magnum in my pocket. Don't fucking play with me like that.
Magnums make your pussy stink.
Oh, well, we can go without Connor. I'm joking. No, we can't. I got a kid already.
Below you guys, okay? This is the difference between the DC Comedy Festival.
Oh, yeah, I don't have to be reserved.
And the Baltimore Comedy Festival.
Because Baltimore is raunchy, man.
Yo.
They raunchy out here. You guys stick with...
It has been fun.
This is his first day.
Dope. This is Eddie Lyles. It's the Love Below, you guys.
See y'all next time.